Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, we will discuss Class 10 Mathematics, Chapter 4, Quadratic Equation, Exercise 4.1, Question Number 2, Sub-Question 3 and 4, Solution. Question Number 2, Sub-Question 3, Rohan's mother is 26 years older than him. The product of their ages in years, 3 years from now will be 360. We would like to find Rohan's present age. So here they have given this situation. We need to represent this in the form of quadratic equation. So here they have asked us to find the Rohan's present age. So we don't know that. So that's why let us say that the age of Rohan is X years. So first we will consider this. We will make let here, that is let the age of Rohan be X years. After that, see, they have given in the situation that Rohan's mother is 26 years older than him. So we have taken the Rohan's age as X and Rohan mother is 26 years older than him means for this X we have to add 26. That forms the Rohan's mother's age. So, we can have based on this situation, Rohan's mother's age is equal to X plus 26 years. Next, see, the product of their ages, that means Rohan's age into Rohan's mother's age is equal to 360. This is given to us, that is when 3 years from now. That means after 3 years, the product of Rohan's age and Rohan's mother's age is equal to 360. This is given to us. So now, first here, to write that, we need to find out Rohan's age after 3 years. See, we have taken that Rohan's age as X years. So after 3 years means X plus 3, right? For example, let us say that there is one person whose age is 25 years now. After 3 years, this person age is 28, 25 plus 3. Same thing is done here. We know that Rohan's age, we have taken that Rohan's age as X years. So after 3 years means X plus 3. So after 3 years, Rohan's age is equal to X plus 3. In the same way, see, we have got from this Rohan's mother age. Next here we need, after 3 years, Rohan's mother's age. That means X plus 26 plus 3. For this you have to add plus 3. So we have here X plus 26 plus 3. This becomes X plus 29. Now we got Rohan's age as well as Rohan's mother's age after 3 years. Next, apply the problem. They have given that the product of their ages after 3 years, that is X plus 3 into X plus 29 is equal to 360. We will write like this way. Next you multiply X into X, X square, X into 29, 29X, 3 into X, 3X, 3 into 29, 87. That is equal to 360. X square 29x plus 3x, that is 32x. So plus 32x plus 87 minus 360 is equal to 0. This I have moved to left hand side, so that becomes minus 360. So 360 minus 87 is minus 273. Here this is the larger value, so here we have to write minus sign. So we got here x square plus 32x minus 273 is equal to 0. This equation, if you compare with the general form of the quadratic equation, this is similar to this. That means we can say that this is the required quadratic equation. Question number 2, fourth sub-question. A train travels a distance of 480 km at a uniform speed. If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. We need to find the speed of the train. See, they have given that here the train travels the distance of 480 km at a uniform speed. So this is given to us, that is distance traveled by the train is equal to 480 km. Next here, we need to find the speed of the train. So let us say that the speed of the train is x kilometer per hour. We don't know the value, so that's why we are taking this as x kilometer per hour. Then we know the formula, speed is equal to distance by time. So distance value I will bring to this side, then the speed will go here, so that we have a formula, time is equal to distance divided by speed. Now in this, apply the value. See, we know the distance, that is 480, and we have taken the speed of the train as x. So from this, we can get the time taken for traveling 480 km. That is, time is equal to distance by speed. Distance is 480 divided by x. Speed we have taken as x. So we got this value. Next, see, in the question they have given, if the speed had been 8 km hours less, then it would have been taken 3 hours more to cover the same. So they have given this situation. If the speed had been 8 km less. See, we have taken the speed as x, right? They have given that speed had been 8 km less. That means we have to deduct from this x 8 km. So x minus 8. So that is x minus 8. So if the speed had been 8 km less means that is x minus 8. Then time taken for traveling 480 km we can write as what? Again, distance divided by speed. Distance is 480 divided by, now you have to take x minus 8, because this they have given, the speed had been 8 km hours less. So that's why x minus 8, now it is not x, x minus 8. Then according to the problem, see, we need to find the speed of the train. So for that purpose, you can deduct this value from this. That is 480 divided by x minus 8 minus 480 divided by x is equal to 3. This you have to do. That is because in the question they have given that after decreasing the speed by 8 km, then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. So here, if you deduct this value from this, then 3 more hours are needed to complete the distance. So we can write 480 divided by x minus 8 minus 480 divided by x is equal to 3. Next here, you can take the LCM. The LCM as x into x minus 8. If I take this as the LCM, x into x minus 8, here in the denominator we have just x minus 8. So our LCM value is x into x minus 8. So you have to multiply this x with the numerator value. So here we get 480x. Then minus, here in the denominator we have just x, but our LCM is x into x minus 8. So you have to multiply this x minus 8 with the numerator value. So 480 into x minus 8 divided by x into x minus 8 is equal to 3. Next, cross multiply, that is 480x minus 480x minus minus becomes plus. So 480 into minus 8, that is plus 3840, that is equal to, see, this value will come here. So we have 3 into x minus 8. So this and this will get cancelled. 3840 is equal to 3x into x, 3x square, 3x into minus 8 minus 24x. Next, bring this value to this side so that here we have the 0. So 3x square minus 24x, so minus 3840. This I have moved to this side. So that becomes minus. That is equal to 0. Now from this you can take the value 3 out. So that is the common value. So we have your x square. If you divide everything by 3, see, 3 will get cancelled. So we have your x square, or you can bring this out. So 3 8s are 24, so minus 8x. Then 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. Then again 3 8s are 24, 0. So minus 1 to 8, 0, that is equal to 0. Now if I take this to this side, that becomes 0 only. So we get the final equation as x square minus 8x minus 1280 is equal to 0. Now this is the required quadratic equation. This particular equation is in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a value is 1 here, which is not equal to 0. So that's why this is our final answer. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Thanks for watching.